Vandegurum students, today let's learn 3-digit subtraction with borrowing and without borrowing. Last class we have learned 2-digit subtraction with borrowing and without borrowing. So you know the story, right? If the circle is down, you have to borrow. If the circle is in the top, no need to borrow at all. Now here also the same rule. Before that, let's know the name of the terms. So the first term, it's called as minuend. What it is called? Minuend. In subtraction, in addition, we will say add and write here minuend. The second term, from which number we are subtracting, it's called a subtrahend. What it is called? Subtrahend. In addition, the answer we will call the sum. Here we will call as difference. This term is called as difference. So even we can, the question can be subtract or find the difference. So the first term is called as minuend. This term is called a subtrahend and the answer is called as difference. You have to write this also one time. So now let's go to the concept. So first, the same rule in 3-digit, 4-digit, whatever also, the same rule, same circle method. First start from ones place. So check which is greater. Yes, 9 is greater. So circle it. Circle is down. Is there a problem? Yes. So we have to borrow. So cancel here. But ones will borrow only from tens. Tens will borrow only from hundreds. So now I borrow means what will happen? It will become 2. Give 1. Actually many of them I have seen they are cancelling 6 and writing here 16. That is wrong method. Actually if you are writing like this when we are doing with 0 you will get confused. You should understand the meaning. We are borrowing 1 and we are giving here 1. Actually this is 110. So you should put here only 1. Don't cancel and don't write here 16. So when you give 1, 16. 16 minus 9, 7. Now again circle method. When you are doing circle method, you should not see the cancelled one. The number is top right, this only you should see. 2 is greater or 1 is greater? Yes, 2 is only greater. The circle is in the top. Should we borrow? No borrowing. 2 minus 1, 1. 5 minus 2, 3. I will teach you few more examples. You have to remember 3 rules. One is you have to start from ones place, then go to tens, next to hundreds. The second rule is ones will borrow from tens. Tens will borrow from hundreds. Third rule is apply circle method. If the circle is down, you have to borrow. If the circle is in the top, no need borrowing. You have to use a circle in ones place also, tens place also. Here no need to use because there is no number here to borrow. So you must use the circle method here and here also. So start from ones place. 4 is greater or 5 is greater? 5 is greater. Should we borrow? Yes, you have to borrow. So cancel 5, give 1. It becomes 14. 14 minus 5, 9. Now, again circle. See, many will think, no need, why I should use in tens place. Now, tens also you have to check whether borrowing is needed. Which is greater? 5 is greater. So, circle is top. No need to borrow. 5 minus 1, 4. 9 minus 2, 7. You should have patience to think. Should we borrow? Then only you have to proceed to the next. Don't subtract from down to up. That is incorrect method. Now again start from ones place. 4 is greater or 7 is greater? 7 is greater. Circle is down. Should we borrow? Yes, we have to borrow. 8, 1. So it becomes 14. 14 minus 7? 7. Again you have to use circle. So in the circle is, if the circle is top, no need to borrow. Direct subtraction. 7 minus 2, 5. So write one number in one box. So what are the terms? This is called minuend, subtrahend, difference.